Hello everyone, today we're going to see how to upload large files with Laravel and React JS. Have you ever needed to upload huge files like movies, songs, or documents? I bet yes. So let's see how we can do this without freezing our browser and also by allowing sending them through a mobile. Well, this technique is called chunk files, which consists in split our huge file into smaller parts, unload them independently, and then reassemble them. So basically, in order to start, we need a project which has Laravel and React JS. Then what we can do is to add a React drag and drop files to make it fancier. So let's just wait until the installation is complete. So now that it's completed, what we can do is that we can place the next code into our resources folder, which is located into the root folder. It's here into the JS and components folder. Here we are going to create another module that is going to be called as upload. So it's here. So it's going to be upload.gsx. So we are going to copy this code. We are going to save it. And in order to have the effect of the changes, remember that we have to run npm run dev, which I'm already running here. And to run PHP, we are going to do PHP artisan serp. Now we are going to load and remember that we also need to add it into our app.js in order to be loaded. So I'm going to import it here. Components, and it's going to be in upload. Well, remember that in React.js, we can call this function from other classes or we can render them directly. So we are going to render them into a div. So I'm going to call it as upload, and I have to add this div ID in our home lathe. So I'm going to create a div which ID is going to be upload. Then I am going to save it and I am going to reload. Okay. So now we have here our drag and drop. Well, this is useful because many people prefer just to drag and drop the files, which makes it easier. The next thing that we are going to do is that we are going to see how this works. So basically, this code has two main things. The main is the file uploader. This is the one that selects the file. So in handle change, we are placing our file. Text and percent is more to provide the feedback of the uploading to the user. Also, we are going to have our upload button, which is going to call this function. Well, basically this function will have our chunk size, which means that how many are we going to send each time that we call the post action. The next thing is that we are going to create a random UID. This is to facilitate when we have multiple files that have the same name, but the content may be different. So the next thing is that we are going to iterate until we reach the size that we are requiring. So the set percent is just for telling the user how many upload has been done. The next thing is that we are going to have the upload chunk, which is going to have the chunk, and in order to do that, we're going to use the slice method of the file, which is going to define like from where we are starting until the end. Then we are going to have the file name, and we are going to know if it is the last chunk or if not. Then here we are going to basically require three things. The first one is the file, which we are going to place the chunk in the file name. Then we can also place the name, but from Laravel we can access the same value by doing get original name from the file info. And its last is going to tell us that if it's the last one, then we just conclude that it's successful. Okay, so then we are going to call this action. Remember to use the await because we want to send them sequentially and not in parallel to avoid that we lose the integrity of the file. So the next thing is to upload that into our endpoint, which we are going to call it as test. We are going to tell them that we are sending multi-part form data. And in case that we get something different to empty, we know that we completed successfully. And that's it. In case that we see an error, we can do two things. We can just tell them that an error occurred and ask them to retry again. Or we can implement a mechanism here to do the retries. The only thing here is that we have to ensure that the integrity of the file, it is not going to be affected. So the next thing that we are going to do is that we are going to go to the Laravel code. Here we are going to go to controllers. Here we have the home controller and we are going to add another file. We are going to call it as concatfile.php. Okay, so I already created it. Then we are going to copy this code and we are going to paste it there. Well, basically this code what is having is that first with our constructor, that is the one that is going to create our files folder. You can customize it. Then this is the one that gets the file name, so we don't really need to pass a name. The next thing is the join file. We are going to use only PHP methods. File put contents allow us to concat files. And since we are using the file app and we can treat them as binary, so you can send any kind of file. The next thing is to check if it's the last one. In that case, we know that our upload is completed successfully and we can just return the path. Otherwise, we return null. The next thing is just to call it in the home controller. And to do that, we are just going to add this code. So here, it's going to create an instance of the concat file since they are in the same folder. We don't need to import it. Then the next thing is just to call the join file and we are done. Only we are missing to add the root into our web.php, which is located in the roots folder. So let's place it here and that's it. So let's just test that if it works correctly. Well, remember that you can send any kind of file here. So I'm going to select first an image and I'm going to upload it. And it says uploaded successfully. So let's just look at here. So let me select revealing file explorer into files. And let's open just to check if it works. So it's working. Another thing that you can do is to check the size. The size should match to the one that you are selecting. So from here, it is matching. Now let's try with a video in order to test our chunks. If you see here, the progress is uploading. So let's try again. Then we're having this size. And from our desktop, let's check the file. Okay, so let's just look again. Yeah, it's done. If you see here, when we are uploading a long file, you are going to see how it is increasing. So let's open just to check the integrity. So now let's try with a bigger one. Let's use this one. And when we click on upload, we're going to be able to see on how it is the process going on. Yeah, you can see here that every time we're getting like more data. Well, if you see, this is a real huge file. So let's just check that it is the correct size, and it is. The other thing that we can do is just to open it and check that everything is working fine. Okay, so yeah, we are done. Please feel free to comment, and thank you for watching.